this video, I'm going to show you AlphaRank, which is an AI-powered analytical tool which uses your Google Search Console and your Google Analytics data to suggest keywords, but also to actually write the content for you. It can even publish it immediately on your website. Let me show you every aspect of this tool and if it's worth the money. If you want to support me making these free videos, I'll be forever grateful. Go to wp.discount/AlphaRank. This link is also in the description of this video or in the comments. And then we are here at the website of AlphaRank, your ultimate SEO companion. I'm of course curious how this works. Then we go over here, press get free trial. Fill in your email address over there and press on email. And then we check our email for the login link. Also check your junk mail and then press in sign in. Here we can start with a website or with keywords. If you fill in your own website, for example wpressdoctor.com, and I press try now, you can see that it will crawl our website. You can see some examples of recommendations because this is just a trial version. Hold on, I'm going to upgrade to the full version. So we're just going to press on back over here and then we're going to start with keywords. Let's try the best WordPress plugin. Press try now. Then we can see the recommendations of AlphaRank. We can see some trending topics. What is the best free plugins for WordPress? All these things. So this looks actually pretty nice. We press on access the full SEO guide. And then immediately is the pricing plan. We are at the free version now. I'm going to show you everything about it. And after that, I'm going to upgrade to the advanced plan so you can see exactly what's all inside of it and if this is really worth $52.50 a month for your website. We press on this cross icon. Then we're going to need our target industry, and this will generate an industry specific SEO guide. So I'm going to fill this website in. Then our industry is electronics, but do fill in, of course, your own industry. And then we press access the report. We have over here a 2024 AlphaRank content guidelines. This looks really interesting. So I definitely want to see this inside of the upgraded version. For now, we're going to press on this cross icon. And then we are at the SEO insights. They just keep popping up things in my face. I don't know why. We have keyword insight. We have technical SEO, content performance, and competitors performance. Let's close this one. Welcome to the dashboard of AlphaRank, this time without any pop-ups. To really show you the power of AlphaRank, I need to add in a website that has actually already been SEO optimized so we can benefit of the true power of AlphaRank. So I'm going to change my website. I go to settings over there. I'm going to change this domain. Click over here. I'm going to change it to https://zepcam.com. And then I press save. Yes, confirm. Then it's going to analyze this website. Now this is a client of mine, so I know exactly that we've been building on SEO for a very long time. So we go back to our dashboard now. Now what do we need to do to actually analyze a website for sure? We need to connect this to Google Search Console. So we click over here and then we're going to press on connect now. Got it. Going to choose my account and press on continue. Then I'm going to press select all and press continue again. Now we are also connected to Google Search Console. Because I've just connected my Google Search Console to my client's website, it might take a day or what to see all this data. Then I'm also going to connect to Google Analytics. Press on connect now. We press on got it. Select your account. And then we click on continue. Then we're going to press on see and download your Google Analytics data and press continue. In here we can see now the Google Analytics data, new users, engagement rate. This is actually pretty nice. Then on the left side we can go to blog writer. Now here we can let AlphaRank create really powerful SEO blogs for our website, and I'm very curious how that happens, so I need to upgrade before we can see this. So hold on just a second, I'm going to show you this. Keyword insight already showed you this, analytics. Then we go to integration. And here you can control the integration with Google Search Console and Google Analytics. But we also have a website builder over here. If I press on connect now, it will ask what for platform are you using. In our case, we're using wordpress.org. You have to fill in your username and your password, and then AlphaRank can connect your WordPress website to automatically post these blogs. Now that's pretty amazing. But I don't think my client will be very happy if I start automatically posting blogs on their website without telling them. Then over here, the pricing, we've already seen this. And then we have the subscription history. Of course, nothing in here. And last but not least, the settings. In here, we can see our website domain. We can change it, our subscription. And then we go to website information. Here we can fill in target countries, marketing goals, target customers, and brand style. Let's do this right now. Then let's add in some marketing goals. Please select our goals. We want to have more organic traffic and, of course, lead conversion. Great. Our main industry is electronics, but actually more in security. Now, they don't have security over there, so we just go with business and industrial because this company is a business-to-business company. Now, the target customers and the brand style has everything to do with how to form the text and what tone of voice it should be using. Our target customers are busy professionals, and our brand style is we are the expert. The main language is English, and the target keywords, we can change them, body cams and body cam, which is the real target keywords. All right. And then we can also go to competitor analysis, and then we can see three actual competitors that are competitors, but the difference is they are in the United States and my client is only based in Europe. But online, they can still be a competitor of each other. And of course, when you have a paid plan, we can go to add even more competitors. So click on start free trial. And then we can see over here, we can go with monthly subscription or a annual subscription, and it will save you 25%. So I would go with annual, and we get a 1 day free trial and we can cancel at any time. I'm going to upgrade to the advanced package and show you everything there is about AlphaRank. Press upgrade now, and then we're going to fill in all our details and press on start trial. Now I am on the advanced plan of AlphaRank. Now the first thing I want to show you is the SEO guide. If you click on this one, look at this. This is not an SEO guide. This is really a marketing SEO strategy. I really love this. When you press on this download button, you get a real extensive guide with more than 170 pages about everything SEO. This is like an SEO masterclass. This is huge. But now it's time to use some really advanced premium features in this dashboard. We have all the keywords inside and all the trending topics for our website. Now let's start with the keyword insight, as that is very important to start with. Click on this one. There are a couple of filters we can use for our keyword research. For example, the keyword difficulty. If the keyword difficulty is low and the search volume is reasonable high, then we can easily rank on this specific keyword. Bodycam, the quality score is 100 because the website is already optimized. And there's a lot of search volume for this one. And the intent is informational. People are not immediately going to buy it. They just have an interest in the bodycam. Here we can see the position of our website on these keywords. The only thing I miss here is a language switcher. So I have position 20 on bodycams. But for example, in the Dutch market, if you look up this keyword, we are ranking on number one. How does this position compare to different kind of languages in the search engine? That would be very interesting. It also could be because of the Google Search Console isn't linked completely the way I want it. We have to wait longer for more information, and then maybe this will change. For now, we are going to look at different kind of keywords that we can actually use to create content for. For example, the bodycam recommended specs. I think this is a very good keyword for the bodycam market because the search intent is also informational, but it also has a commercial layer behind it. So this could be very interesting to create some content about. If you look at all these keywords, you get a lot of information about your website that would be interesting to create some content about it. So let's say I want to create content about a keyword. You just go over here. Here on the right side, we can actually delete this entire keyword because it's not relevant. For example, the phone cam. I don't think it's relevant. So we can delete it. And here we can select the reason for deletion. That's the way you can do it. You can also press on this icon. And then it will favorite for later use. And we can also immediately write a blog. So let's press on this button. Here we can definitely see the power of AI, which AlphaRank is using. They are recommending different kinds of keywords to create some blogs around it. And we're going to give it a shot. We're just going to create blog posts for all of these search keywords. Why not? First, we're going to select the blog tone. I want to be an expert in this field because the target audience is business to business. If you're selling business to consumer, you might want to go with persuasive or supportive. It's totally up to you and your tone of voice of your website. Then we're going to select the target countries. Let's first go with the United Kingdom. If you also want to add in some internal links from our website inside these blogs, you can put them in there. Really smart. The link I'm going to use is the new Zepcam T3 Live Bodycam. Why not? Press on learn more and then we are here. I'm just going to copy this entire link and then I'm going to paste it in over there. Then we press next step. So this link should be included in the blogs. Now here we are generating topics based on the Google search results. When using AI, this is what makes me happy. These topics are really on point. I love this. This AI is doing a good job. Well, I think they're all good, but I can't select multiple. So we're just going with the first one and press next step. I really like this user interface. It has the H1 title of your blog. Then we are starting with different kind of subjects, H2, H2, H2. And within the subject, we have H3s with all the different kind of subjects. Here we can just change the text, change the titles. We can add more content, remove it. We can regenerate the entire outline. This is a really great tool. Let's generate this entire blog post. Here we go. And after 30 seconds, I get this entire new blog post. If I click on it, here we can see all the information of this blog. It's awaiting publication. The reading time is only 2 minutes. It's in English. We have different kind of keywords. We have one internal link. The country is the United Kingdom and the tone is expert. We can see over here the search appearance, how it will look in the search engine. And what I like about this overview is that you can still change it. For example, when I change the title, just press edit and change it the way you want to. And then we are at the blog content. I've read it entirely and I know how my client thinks. And this is actually a pretty good blog to post on our website. But of course, we still need to tweak and tune it a little bit to put in our own product right there and maybe adding some more content to this one. But the basis of this blog post is really, really good. What I would like to see, however, is over here somewhere that we can see how many words are inside of this blog, because I cannot see it right now and I also cannot change it. Of course, I can do it the manual way and we can see it's 543 words. But I would just really like to see over here, or maybe a few steps earlier, how many words do you want this blog post to be approximately? I would say 1600 words. Press on generate and there we are. So that's one thing I really would like to see within AlphaRank. Another thing I want to show you is this image, definitely created by AI. And if I right click on this and press on inspect, you can see that the alt text over here, bodycam recommended specs, is actually right on point. The problem is this image doesn't look like bodycams at all. This is just some phones or tablet kind of stuff. It would be nice to also have a button in here to regenerate only the image. But on the other hand, you might have images from your own website you want to use inside of these blog posts and you don't want to use AI generated images at all. I can completely agree with that one. We can press on apply, apply to my website, create a new page, or we can change over here to status so that it has been published if you don't want to publish it immediately. And if I now go back to my blog writer and on this specific post, you won't see this apply button over here. And then we have another button over here, which says view effect. Now, if I click on this right now, I just go to the blog information because it hasn't been published yet. So this publish link is not okay. So measuring the effects of this blog is still really hard right now as it is not live. But it would be really awesome if you can press on view effect. We're going to analytics. And in here, we can see that this blog definitely did something with our impressions, our average position on a specific keyword. That would be very, very awesome. Talking about analytics, let's dive into these ones as we have now the advanced plan. If we look further down, we can see all the Google Analytics data, users and all these times, and we can see the users amount in the past month. Then we can over here see engagement rate. So how many pages do they click through? I can see it's almost one. average, also the average engagement time. This might be the seconds, how long they are on your website. It's always difficult to measure this. I always find this very difficult, because if you leave your screen open and it's open somewhere, but I'm multitasking, is it still active engagement time? I don't think so. But always with analytics, it's always a question. Then we can see the users by country. If we scroll up, we go to organic keywords. Now, in here, we can see a lot of keywords and we can also filter them. Now, if you have one language on your website, this is really, really interesting and useful. Because if we click on impressions, for example, and we click again on it, we can see that the most impressions come from the word bodycam. Now, remember, this is not the search volume. This is your website being shown in the Google search result page 659 times in the period of last month. We cannot change the period in here, but okay. And it generated 7 clicks, so the click-through rate is 0.01, which is really, really low. This means if you want a certain page to rank on this specific keyword, we can create more blocks to it, link to that specific page, or just create more content that will go into these places. Now, this information is vital to create your SEO strategy on the long run. Really interesting to go through this. Again, I would really like to see some language features, but hey, if you only have one language on your website, this is actually pretty amazing. Let's go to your organic pages. Again, we have some filters in here. Now, if we sort them on position, we can see that the body cam in the Netherlands, body cam police, is actually on the position number 4. So if you look for, I think, body cam politie, in Dutch, body cam police, it will generate 48 clicks because we're in a high position. If the police is looking for new body cams, this is a very interesting market. We also have the home pages. Then we can see that most clicks are generated by the Dutch version of the website. This might be the cause because it's a Dutch company, so they might be doing their best marketing effort inside of the Netherlands. Very interesting to click through this, change the impression rate to see what kind of position you are on and change your SEO strategy according to this. Really nice. Now, another thing I want to point out to you is the trending topics. Now, with trending topics, you never know if they are related to your business, but it comes up in the AI, so the AI is thinking, well, it might be relevant. However, if you look at all of these trending topics, they are just all about the bodycam PC game. And it's a trending topic because this game has been released a couple of months ago. So yes, it's in there. Problem is, it has nothing to do with our professional body cams. So as with the keyword inside, where I can just delete the keywords and tell the AI why I want to delete them, this would be also very nice to see on the trending topics to learn the AI system that this is completely not relevant to our business. But again, this is a trending topic and it is about body cams, so it actually did a good job. So now you know exactly what to expect from AlphaRank. I really like the keyword insights, the analytics, and the blog writer is really doing a great job at creating content for my keywords. If you have any questions, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Have a great day and I'll see you in the next video.